We've now come to our final award of the night, and it's only 12:30. The ceremony's ultimate accolade, the Great Scott. It's a bird somewhere. As you'll be well aware by the standard of the stories we've heard tonight, it's been a very tough call for our judges, as our next guest will testify. Will you please pay your warmest respects to the chairman of the judging panel and the man regarded by many as one of Scotland's finest legal minds, Lord McCluskey.
Your Honour, please, gotta believe what I say. What I will tell.
The winner for 2001, a nurse who through personal sacrifice has given great hope to asthma sufferers, a worthy successor to George and all the other great Scots of the last decade.
Peter Smith cuts the grass at his home in Cardross. Nothing unusual in that, you might think, but just a few short months ago, it wouldn't have been possible.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Fine, thank you.
Good,
very well.
Good. Tell me, how have you been since the last
Not a lot better. A lot more energy than I used to have.
Good.
I'm able to go for my paper every morning and without coughing. And, yeah, I do my exercise regularly.
Good. How have you found Peter Helen?
Oh, marvellous. Just, I've got my husband back.
Oh, that's lovely.
After,
oh,
you know, he's just, he's been really so well since May.
A reaction like Peter and Helen's is music to Jill McGowan's ears, because Jill, who's a nursing lecturer at Paisley University, has invested heavily in promoting a treatment for asthma which doesn't involve the use of nebulizers and drugs. With almost evangelical zeal, Jill advocates the Bocato breathing technique. Why? Because it worked for her, and she believes it will work for thousands of others.
I had what you would call very, very brittle asthma. Taking the regular medication didn't always work for me because I had particular triggers, the main one being cats. If a cat had come into this room 4 years ago, I would have had this on full blast within minutes. One evening at my work with a general practitioner who actually introduced me to this method, Dr. Gerard Spence, I was going in to sort of set up for the evening at the reverse service, and there must have been a cat in the room, and right away my chest went tight and I started to wheeze. Now, anyone who's asthmatic will tell you that you lose the hand-eye coordination and dexterity, so I could not undo the safety pin and get the drug keys to get myself an inhaler. Jerry was aware of my movements, knew something was wrong, came through, got me on the nebulizer, and said, you need to learn this method.
Most train of thought has centered on asthma causing hyperventilation, but the Russian professor Bocato believes it's the other way round, that hyperventilation causes asthma and that it can be controlled with the right breathing technique.
So I'll demonstrate it for you now. If I take my breath in through the nose, out through the nose, I'll hold my breath, hold my nose, and... And remember, when you start to breathe again, you breathe in through your nose and keep your mouth closed.
But getting the medical profession to invest in research is, according to Jill, a chicken and egg situation, with clinical trials necessary to provide scientific evidence that the technique works. So, frustrated at the lack of progress, Jill took an extraordinary step.
I have learned this method in 1996. It took me to 2000, and the only reason it got off the ground was because I put my money where my mouth is. I'm better. I had a house, my daughters had grown up, one had left home, the other one was about to leave home. What did I need a three-bedroom detached house for? It had equity, get rid of it. And that's what I did. I sold the house. And that's what got the clinical trial started.
The pilot study is ongoing at Shettleston Health Centre, and clinical trials are now underway at two hospitals in and around Glasgow. Jill's positive they will lead to only one conclusion, saving many of the 1,600 lives lost and some of the £100 million spent on treatment each year in Scotland.
Doesn't matter how long it takes. I know this works. Part of my code of conduct as a nurse is that if I have to remain abreast of current trends, and if I know of anything that is non-medicalised, non-invasive, then that's what I should promote for my patients. I would advocate for each asthmatic patient that Bocato breathing will certainly change their life.
It's meant I've got my life back. Before I started the technique, I was on eight different medications. a day. And that I'm down to one now, and that has been halved from what it was. Now I go to the gym twice a week, I go swimming three times a week, I'm working full time, and I can go out at the weekends. It's brilliant.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Sunday Mail Great Scott 2001, Jill McGowan. What have you done today to make you feel proud? It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud? Mm-hmm. You could be so many people if you make that grab for freedom. What have you done today?
What can I say? My good friend Margaret Solis said to me earlier on today, sit down and take 10 minutes to think of something to say to people. And I thought, I don't need to say anything. My thanks go to a professor in Russia called Konstantin Pavlovich Buteyko, who made a discovery in 1952, I think it was, before I was born. And it took him to 1985 to get it endorsed by the Ministry of Health in Russia as the first line management for asthma. My life as a nurse, as a practice nurse, was to help patients with asthma. And when I learned through a GP in Shettleston Health Centre called Jerry Spence about the Buteyko technique and how it helped me with my asthma, I became almost dedicated to finding out how this would better people. And for me, it does help my patients. You saw the short film that was made about people, Helen, who said she got her husband back in Peter, and Susan, who I'm externally humbled to, who put me forward for this nomination, for this award. I mean, Susan has got her life back, and that's fantastic. At the end of the day, I'm just a nurse doing a job, which I love and what I'm dedicated to. My code of conduct tells me if there's anything that's non-invasive, non-medicated, that can help people, then by rights I should carry that forward and find out about it and keep abreast of current trends. And that's what this is all about. This is for our NHS and for nurses making things better for patients. And let's hope we can take it forward. To all the unsung heroes who are here tonight, every one of them is just an honour for what they've done. For the lady who's got the children that with spina bifida, for the gentleman who had cerebral palsy, and for everybody else, for the lady who had the car accident where she was paralysed, all of you, it's wonderful that you were honoured tonight, and this is very, very special to me. Thank you very, very much.